Hello, welcome back my little starlings to another video featuring yours truly, Morningstar. Today we are going to be deconstructing what will be the Rose Manor. So in the series of the Let's Play with Meet the Roses, so Axel and Jada purchased this house on this lot in Bridlington Bay. It is right now called Chateau Frise. I think that's how you say it. I'm terrible at pronouncing names or words that are not clearly English. So I purchased this lot, and I think it's gonna, I don't know if it's gonna be Rose Manor or Rose Chateau. One of those. So something to do with roses, because obviously they are the roses. And I am just, here you can see I am trying to decide on what fireplace I was going to go with, but honestly I changed directions and I decided to just wipe 99% of the stuff out, and so I'd have like a blank canvas to design from. I've never ever gone through a pre-built house like this and redone it, so this is kind of new and interesting and should be kind of fun. So the idea behind this is that they bought this house and now they're gonna make it their own, renovate it their own style. So roses are gonna be incorporated into the whole theme somehow. It's gonna be roses and beachy. I don't know if beachy or shabby chic, if any of those really, it's gonna be, this is hard. I guess kind of shabby chic beachy feel, but with lofty modern elements that are kind of masculine thrown in there for Axel. And hopefully that all turns out pretty cool. Some of the things that I did do just a few minutes before this voiceover, and you're not going to probably see, is that I did add a basement, and I also took out the wall. Where is it? Where that bookcase thingy is. I took out that wall and made it all open. So there were some changes, but there are also going to be more changes as we go. So elements will be constructed and reconstructed and so on and so forth. And the reason why I did add a basement is because I have found that when you have the butlers, the house stays so much more cleaner. I hate having to pick up after my Sims. I hate picking up after myself, let alone the Sim. So that's why I always have a butler. They don't do all of the work, but they do a lot of it. Plus they'll entertain the baby if it's crying. They'll help out there. So while just having a nanny or just a maid or just a butler is kind of not worth it, if you have all three, it becomes more worth it. So I don't know if anyone else does that when they are playing, but that is the whole reason why I made the basement, because you can assign the butler a room and his room will be downstairs, and I think a gym will also be downstairs, something of the sort. We'll see, because you only have 8 Sims. I wonder if he counts as an 8th. I don't think so. Excuse me. So we will definitely see. Now while I might, like the outside I did make white as well, white and black. I like that. I don't know if it's them, so that might change as well. There are so many different elements in this that will probably change, because you know, rose, the whole rose theme is super super important, and I really want to get that across. And a lot of this probably will contain some custom content just because of the whole theme I'm going for. Of course there is not all of this type of a, there are not these types of rose themes throughout the Sims decor. I mean, there's a lot of floral and flowers, definitely. Like I could probably do the whole rose garden section just without custom content, because there's a lot of roses and flowers in the game packs. And but as for the indoor, I just might be doing some custom content there. And if I do, I will link it down below. So if you like it, you can go download it. And hopefully, because it'll work for me, it'll be okay for you. No promises made. I have downloaded a pack that I think I might have mentioned this before. I feel like I'm repeating myself sometimes. I did download a pack that, a mod that did royally screw up my game. And it's worked for other people. So I don't know if it was just how I installed it or if I had another mod that conflicted with it. There could have been a few different reasons. So basically I've emptied out the whole folder and I'm adding in things one by one. But I did notice I get this script call error a lot. So I need to look into how to go about and fix that. Hopefully it's not too bad, because there's a lot of items that I want to use that do have that script call error. It makes me so sad. It might also have to do with the fact that I'm using a Mac and not a PC. That always seems to screw a lot of things up. It frustrates me. I know PCs are mostly used for gaming, but I have a Mac because I'm a designer, and so that is just the way it's going right now. Maybe one day in the future I will have that PC. I think I've spoke about this before in the last one too. And we'll see. We'll go from there. So anyway, yeah, every video will probably be about I don't want a video longer than five minutes. This one's 13 minutes and 51 seconds before I add the intro and outro. So maybe around there. Some might be a little bit longer depending on, like, you know, if I include all the bedrooms, or, you know, the kitchen, the dining room, and the family room. So it depends on what I feel like doing that day, and then we can go along with the story of the roses. So now they're married. I did create them already married. So technically they did buy their house when when Jay turned 16. She's just a little bit older. So when she turned 16, she bought this house, and in the game that we do play, 16 is considered an adult. And so don't go screaming mean things in the comments. The game it's a European based game, so their age differences are, you know, what's considered an adult there considered the United States, compared to the United States, is completely different ages. Here it's 18, there it is 16. So in that game, they move out when they're 16, but you can't get married till you're 18. So I'm gonna start this off when they're 18, and they're just gonna be buying this house later, and it should be a lot of fun. I'm like really anxious to start. I've never played or done a Let's Play, and so I've been binge watching them on YouTube, getting some ideas, and I found this really scandalous one. What's her name? Carmen King. Whew. Super scandalous, but super entertaining. So I recommend you check her out if you like watching Let's Plays on Sims, and it just goes crazy. Like, crazy ass channel. I love it. And I love that she just says what she wants to and plays how she wants to. It's great. So check that one out. I'll link her channel down below. And so anyways, stay tuned. Hopefully I can have another portion of this out soon, because I can't really start anything role-playing Let's Play wise until this house is done, because this is their residence. This is the main area of their concern. Axel still needs to start his job. Jade was a stripper at the beginning, so I don't even know if there is a stripper mod. I'm afraid to install that. So we just might have to play a little pretend there. And this was a lot of fun. So I hope you enjoyed watching how I would go about deconstructing a pre-built Max's house. And we'll see how I I don't know if it's improving or just different. Different styles for, you know, different people. And stay tuned, and thank you for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you don't, just walk out through the door, you know, turn your computer off, just pretend you didn't even watch it. And if you would be so kind, hit subscribe and that little bell button for notifications to stay tuned for the Rose Saga. as well as my other future sim builds. And I will catch you guys shortly for another sim build. Bye!